Here comes our tow.
Gosh.
He pulled in and he got stuck. We pulled over to the side of the road, and this is what happened. I think we're gonna have to call a tow truck. We called the tow service and he asked us if we have AAA, and we told him we didn't. And so then Sal realized that we have Good Sam. The tow guy is here. I think he's the only person in the area, but he has to wait until they call him. So we have to wait until he gets the call, and then he's gonna get us out of here. You said he should be here in about 2 hours. Okay. All right, well then I guess we'll try to wait for him. We just got a call from Latoya at Good Sam, and she said that she wasn't able to use the local company here, S&R Towing, and the guy actually was passing by and he was really nice to us, but she said they're not in her network. So they're actually sending someone that's in their network from Desert Hot Springs, California, which is an hour 89 miles away.
Hello.
An hour and 36 minutes.
Yes. Yes, that's where we are. Hold on, let me give you to my wife. She might know better.
Hello? Yes, we're in a fifth wheel and we're stuck on the side of the road in sand, and we're in Borrego Springs. We're on to Giorgio. Oh, okay. How far are you? 98 miles? 98 miles. Okay. Well, there's a towing service here, but Big Sam won't use them. Or Good Sam. There's an actual towing service here that's local, but we have to wait an hour and a half for you to get here because Good Sam won't use them. Oh, we're right. We're only 2 feet off the road. We're right on the road.
Yeah.
But are you on the way now? Oh, okay.
Right. I'll have to remember that in case that ever happens again then. Yeah, keep one set of wheels right on the blacktop.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah, this is all desert. You're right. All right, well, we'll be here waiting for you. All right. Yep, thank you, sir. Thank you. Bye.
So I talked to Good Sam, and they can't use the company that's local here because they're not in their network, so she had to find someone in their network. It took about an hour for her to find somebody, and then she called me back and she said that they're using service from Desert Hot Springs, California, which is 89 miles away from here, and they said it would take about 2 hours for them to get here, so that would put us at about 3 hours from the time we first called them, because we called them over an hour ago, probably 3.5 hours from the time we got stuck. So, but hopefully he'll get here soon. I guess we're gonna wait it out. Are we gonna wait it out?
I think so. Yeah, I think. And then he also said something that they do is they take the air out of the tires sometimes and bring the tire pressure down, and that's how one way that they get people out when they're really stuck inside in the desert, and like inland somewhere.
Well, on that note, our tires are completely full. Because we just had our tires filled. We just had a new tire put on, so our tires are full. He filled all of our tires, so I wonder if that contributed to us getting stuck.
Yeah, I wonder. Wouldn't that be something? But that's okay.
So, well, hopefully we'll get out of here soon. I think this is affecting our ability to go to the ocean today, but we'll see. In order to not get stuck, you leave one set of tires on the pavement. So if we had done that, we wouldn't have gotten stuck. We would have been sticking out on the road, though. That's the only thing, but
right.
I don't know.
Well, he said traffic should go around you. But in theory, that's true. That they should go around you, but you never know. You know, you want to get off the road. So.
Yeah. So, okay. Well, wait. It is now 2:50 p.m. We originally got stuck at around 1:12 p.m. or maybe a little bit before that, about 1 p.m. I'd say. We originally got stuck around 1 p.m., so we've been here almost 2 hours. So, okay, we'll check back in later.
This is like just horrible sand. It's just sand. It's like a beach that we got on, unfortunately.
We're still waiting here. Sal's much more patient with waiting than I am. I don't like waiting, but I have my game. I play a game called Idle Miner Tycoon. I like games. Probably $2. I used to play a game on Facebook called Family Farm. And I was on it so much that I finally just decided to give it up. I don't want to spend my life on this game. So I gave it up. And I think I gave it up probably 2 or 3 years ago. But now I play this Idle Miner Tycoon. It's not too bad. It's on my phone. Here comes our tow.
Oh my gosh, I hope he doesn't get stuck.
Oh my god.
Oh my gosh.
He pulled in and he got stuck.
He told me not to pull into this thing. Yeah, get that.
Leaving my cats. I think he's trying to pull himself out.
Should I put the truck in neutral or something?
No, Sal. He's trying to pull himself.
Okay, gotcha.
He's trying to get one tire of his on the road so he can get out. He's stuck. So it looks like the tow truck that came to get us is stuck. But we'll see.
You think he can get us out?
were almost out for a second there, but I guess not quite yet. Just pulled over. I don't know if he's gonna try to help us. Yeah, it looks like he's gonna try. The Good Samaritan's gonna help pull out the tow truck.
So they're gonna pull him out first, right? Oh my gosh. Yeah, he's pulling out. Look at that. Guy's honking.
He's honking because they were in his way. He wanted to fly by.
That's a good thing he didn't. I think he'll get us out now.
So the Good Samaritan pulled the tow truck out, so hopefully we're next. The Good Samaritan just left. So I don't know. Hopefully we'll get out of here. Look at all that. And then the driver's side tire got really stuck. Look at this. That's really high. It was almost up to the sideboard where you get into the truck. This is where the tow truck was stuck.
I don't know what to say at this point. That was a lot of work. I thought we'd get out of here out of that a lot easier than we did. That was harder than I thought it would be. Thank God we're out of there. It took a lot. I won't be stopping on the side of the road anytime soon in California, I think.
The tow truck got here a little over an hour ago. It's 5:41 p.m. and we got stuck at about 1. So that's about 4 hours and 40 minutes later. So we're glad to be out. We're glad to be out. Did you have anything to say, Seth?
I'm just glad to be out, too. That was quite an ordeal. But we're out, so that's all that matters.
We're on our way. We're unstuck, we're on our way, and almost time for sundown, so looks like we're not going to be able to leave Borrego Springs tonight, so we're going to go back to the campsite we were at earlier.
Yeah, bummer. But what are you going to do? It's just, it got too late, and I think we're tired, so we're just going to go back to the campsite and maybe head out tomorrow.
Below.
And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.